Welcome back to Q&A. We're delighted to have your company. Coming up on the program, young voters, where do they disappear to? How do we get them back? And the public service, are there cuts ahead? But first, one of the areas National is promising their biggest set of changes in is the property market, impacts on the property market, impacts on renters, the whole lot. So Whena Owen went to look at how the industry is responding to National's election win.
With pre-election polls signalling a shift to the right, players in the property market were already at the starting line. The election night result, they say, has brought clarity.
It was an aha moment for people who realised that this is actually going to happen.
The phones have definitely started ringing from some groups of buyers are out there, in particular investors, so they're starting to look to re-enter the market because of the change of government.
Property investor and tutor Steve Goody advertised his upcoming investment seminar before the election with little response.
Post-election, suddenly all of our webinars are full and interest is back, and we've got a lot of ticket sales for that just in the last few days. I think everybody's come back to the fact that the sun's going to come out, there's going to be another day, and that we're situation normal again.
And on top of that, there are extra incentives for investors. National's proposed fiscal shifts and policy repeals aimed at providing more housing stock for buyers and renters.
What I'll be saying to you is that we are going to put downward pressure on rents by actually unwinding the bright line test from 10 to 2 years,
right,
and unwinding interest deductibility and changing some of the tenancy law.
Tax non-deductibility, it's basically made every rental property in New Zealand worth a little bit less, which means that now with it being taken out again over a period of time by this proposed National Act coalition, that every rental property in New Zealand is going to go up in value a little bit more. It also means that we don't have to do the 90 days to evict a bad tenant anymore. We can do the no-cause evictions. Now, I'm on the fence whether that's a great idea or not.
Not such a good idea for tenants, is it?
Well, no.
The election result really is a bad forecast for renters.
Over in Wellington's Aroa Valley, Renters United President Geordie Rogers is not feeling the post-election glow.
If I was a landlord, I'd be rubbing my hands. It's plenty of money going into my back pocket. I can guarantee that renters won't see a single cent of that, and Treasury agrees with that analysis too.
At the other end of the market, foreign eyes are on a piece of paradise. National also promises to partially repeal the ban on foreign buyers by allowing them to purchase properties valued above $2 million if they paid a 15% buyer's tax.
I just think that $2 million cap might be a little bit low. If it was at $5 million, would a lot of international buyers looking at New Zealand as an immigration bridge to buying a property here and moving here, would they see the difference between $2 and $5 million?
Would the $2 million threshold also have a bit of a negative impact on people wanting to get into the market here?
It could possibly, yes. The 15% tax helps, but a couple trying to purchase a $1.7 million property that are beaten because that $1.7 million property becomes worth $2 million so that it can compete internationally, they're going to feel a little bit beat up.
In this week after the election, potential buyers from overseas were already hitting local property pages.
There's been quite a uptake in traffic through the website, particularly from the USA and Australia over the last week since the election.
Mark Harris is Managing Director of New Zealand Sotheby's International.
We're not making too many promises at the moment. Obviously, Winston's still involved behind the scenes.
He says in times of upheaval elsewhere, New Zealand is often seen as a safe haven.
I hate to say it, sometimes other areas of the world going through suffering and pain has seen an inquiry pick up in this part of the world, and that's sort of understandable, isn't it, when you look at a place like New Zealand and consider it a safe haven. It'll be interesting over the next few weeks, obviously with everything going on in the Middle East, if we notice a pick up from that part of the world.
But back in Wellington, are people reluctant to buy and sell right now? This is a public servant's town, and National and ACT have promised to slash jobs.
Yes, there'll certainly be people out there a bit worried about what's next for me, particularly with the language coming from the new government. But one of the things that we see is that when a new government comes in, any change of government, they will have new projects, they will be doing something different, wanting to implement new things, and a lot of those people will get shifted around.
While the last few years has seen little activity from investors, it's been good for first home buyers. What's next?
I don't have a crystal ball. My best guess would be that we're going to see a lot more volume come back, a lot more sales transactions are going to happen because they've been unnaturally low. It's been a tough couple of years, so you know, it is great to have some enthusiasm back. And you know, we don't want to see prices multi-year capital gains. It's bad for society. What we want is volumes to come back so buyers, sellers and agents can transact again.
And they're not wasting any time. Next weekend, investors gather for their industry conference in Queenstown.